Hi, my name is Megan Root. I am the founder of the Sculpt Society and celebrity fitness instructor, and this is how I work it. I'm so excited to take you through 24 hours of my beauty and wellness routine while we are in quarantine. Once people started socially distancing, I immediately started doing live stream workouts from my New York City apartment. I wanted to bring a sense of normalcy for anyone who was working out with me, give them a way to continue to work out with me.
We're all in this together. You are not working out alone.
So I'm live streaming on the Sculpt Society app 2 to 3 times a day, 7 days a week.
So strong, you have it. On those hands, we're going from the top.
The classes are ranging from anywhere between 10 to 50 minutes. So I'm really tired. The most challenging part of my job right now is trying to keep content fresh, and that takes a lot of time and a lot of prep. The best part of this is the messages I receive every single day from people who are telling me that I'm helping them get through this quarantine time. This community means so much to me. I could get really emotional about it, but sorry. I'm tired, but when I get a message from them, it really fuels me. Fitness is really powerful, and everyone just needs a moment, whether it's 5 minutes or 10 minutes, to move their bodies, to get out of their minds, and just to feel good. And if I can be that person for them, it really means so much to me.
Good morning. It is 7:15 and I have to get up.
I'm trying to wake up at 7 or 7:30 every day, even if I don't have a live class until 9:30.
Got a long day of filming ahead of me. I actually want to show you my view of New York City. Get the day started.
My morning routine pre and post COVID has always been, first thing, I get a big jug or a cup of lukewarm water. I'll put in half to a whole lemon. I'll chug that.
Naturally, my favorite part of my morning routine is my coffee, my French press.
So boiling water, letting it sit for about 3 minutes and plunge in it.
I'm just drinking my coffee. I need a little energy for my live that's happening.
I'll do a short meditation on the Sculpt Society app.
I also really don't feel like meditating this morning, but I'm going to do it. Kelsey Patel has some amazing meditations on the Sculpt Society app, and they're all under 8 minutes.
I'll meditate, and then I'll start getting ready for my day. The first day, I was like, woohoo, no makeup, no, like, I can be in my sweatpants, can sleep in. It sounds great, but for me, it just puts me not in a great mood. There's something about feeling put together and confident that just starts your day off better. Now, the Sculpt Society colors are navy, blush, white, black, and gray. So when I first launched, those were the only colors I was wearing on the Sculpt Society app, so it looked really uniformed. Obviously, I'm in a very bright pink outfit right now, and that brightens my day, having a little bit more fun with the outfits.
Getting in the mood for some dance cardio, so I decided to put on maybe the brightest set that I own.
There's something about being on camera in a bright outfit, and people get a little bit more excited about it. In the morning, I don't wash my face, but I'll splash water on the face, then do a serum and a moisturizer.
And I kind of just rotate between all of these products.
And then I'll apply my makeup.
I am getting ready for my live stream, and I'm gonna put some makeup on.
My makeup, if I'm filming content for the app, is just a little bit more than I normally would wear day to day. When you're filming for videos, you just want a little bit more coverage, but I definitely wanna keep my makeup natural.
So I'm gonna start with this Tula primer with a little bit of this Glow Drop by Supergloop, and then BB cream.
I'll put some concealer under my eyes.
On my eyelids, then around my nose.
I'll then put some bronzer on.
Using this Tarte bronzer. By the way, this is like getting ready very fast for me. I usually take about 10 minutes, but I've got about 5 today. And then I'll use this blush here. Put it on my cheekbones.
I'll fill in my eyebrows.
I'll use this Tarte palette for their chocolate brown. And I'll just dab the Sephora, like, I don't know what you call this. And I'll just fill in my eyebrows. I love a thick brow. I usually get my eyebrows tinted, but because of quarantine, it's been a little bit of time. Just go in and lightly fill them in. Again, I still want it to look natural. And then I use this Maybelline Great Lash Clear Mascara to just shape them a little bit more. Kind of like to brush my eyebrows up. I don't know if that's even in like a technique, but curl my eyelashes. And then the finishing touch is just this Maybelline Define Lash Mascara.
It's not waterproof mascara. I've gone through stages of waterproof and non-waterproof. I love that waterproof doesn't smudge when I'm sweating. However, taking it off bugs me, so I generally stick to regular.
And there you go.
If I'm filming, I'll do a little makeup spray. Yeah, a setting spray. I find that that actually will hold my makeup pretty well, and Hoola has a really nice one, as well as Supergoop. That I like.
Next up, I gotta figure out this hair situation.
I do wear a bun a lot. I either wear a bun or I'll wear a ponytail and I'll curl the ends of the ponytail.
Don't like to overwash my hair, especially because I have it up all the time. So I probably wash my hair like twice a week.
I'm a big believer in hairspray. So the old school like ballet dancer in me likes like a slick back bun. This is a little bit more volume these days, which is probably better. But yeah, I like a strong hairspray. Big fan of that. I love just a generic like thick elastic band that you can get at like a Duane Reade. I also have these like slip ones that are like, it's kind of like an old school scrunchie that I like.
I really hold my hair, especially for a bun.
Or these two other fun ones, I don't know what they're called. I try and use natural deodorant. I love Mega Babe. Arm & Hammer has a good one.
There you go, you got your Sculpt Society bun, and you're ready to go.
I'm setting up for the live.
Right before I go on, it's always just slightly stressful. I've set up the live stream on my camera. Microphone, plugging that into the iPhone. All right.
Welcome to the Sculpt Society, guys.
Happy, what day is it? It's Tuesday.
We're gonna do a quickie full body using the TSS booty band and then a little core action on the back.
Let's get into it, yeah?
When we first started socially distancing, I started streaming live on my app and I was so excited about it.
Thank you so much for being here. This is my first live, so bear with me if we have any technical issues.
It was incredibly stressful in the beginning. There were multiple times where the live shut off and I didn't realize I'm learning so much about tech right now, and I apologize to anyone who's frustrated. I promise I'm gonna get better. This is all just a learning experience, so I'm rolling with it. I finally ordered an Ethernet cable that would connect into my iPhone. I have noticed when I do live stream on my app later in the day, because there are more people on the internet, sometimes that 12:30 time slot, Wi-Fi connection can be a little bit tricky streaming online.
I'm gonna turn the Wi-Fi on. 30 seconds, guys, I promise.
My new studio is a 300 square foot living room in my New York City apartment. Fortunately, I have not heard from my neighbors, which either we've got really thick walls and they can't hear, or they're just letting me do my thing. Morgan filmed a really funny video coming out of the elevator while I was doing a live workout, and you can like hear me like screaming. Which, by the way, is really tough. My voice has been a little bit raspy because I've been projecting so much, and then the music's blaring.
Double step touch.
I'm just really happy that I haven't had a complaint. There's an energy in a studio that I think is hard to replicate. And when you are on your own, you're having to really find that energy for everyone.
You're crushing it at home. I can feel you. Stick with it.
There is something about being in studio collectively with 30 women and you're just all dancing together and sweating together. However, there is something even more special about thousands of people tuning in live together.
There is something about a community coming together for a little positivity in this stressful time.
That's the sticky part of the Sculpt Society, is this community of women who can come into a boutique fitness studio or online and feel like they're a part of something. I really wanted everyone, every size, every shape, to feel represented and seen. I wanted to make the Sculpt Society a method for non-dancers.
The dance cardio is all follow along. Simple, it's repetitive, it's fun, and guess what? No one's watching you.
I consistently remind people, no one's watching you. Everyone's in their own world, even if you're at a studio. There's something really empowering and uplifting once you realize that and can let yourself just go.
Woo!
And then the real bulk of the method is sculpting, so that it felt athletic and it, like, anyone at any level could walk in off the street and feel really successful.
If at any point you're like, whoa, this girl is moving super fast for me and I'm finding this really advanced, slow the movement down. Everything can be modified. Make sure it feels good for you and your body. And the more you do it, the more you master it, the stronger you're gonna get.
My routines are constantly changing. I'm constantly trying to mix it up so that every 9:30 isn't the same. During this time, it was really important to me to show people that just your body weight can deliver a really solid workout. I don't actually have hand weights here at my apartment, and I've been using cans of beans in all of my live workouts. My arms have been sore from those cans of beans. There's always ways to make it work if you don't have equipment.
If you don't have a Pilates ball, grab a small pillow. But again, everything can be done with no equipment, so do not worry.
Something I love about the Sculpt Society app is that people can comment in and I can read messages.
Let's get to know each other, ask me something.
And I can connect with people after every single class.
Comment on the video if you have any questions. I'll go through some of those questions after class and we can drink coffee together and chat.
You can see who it's from and they can tell me where they're tuning in from.
Haley in Chicago, Sarah in DC. We got Annie in Poland, Caroline in Germany. What's up?
People from around the world tuning in live with all of us.
You worked so freaking hard.
After my first class, I log off I look at the stats, I assess, and then I frantically get ready for the second live. I wanna be prepared, I go through the content, the playlist,
and I'll just quickly review what I'm gonna be doing. Don't mind me.
And I'm gonna have some breakfast, and that is granola, yogurt, almond milk, and then I'm gonna probably put some almond butter. So that time in between goes by really quickly. If I've done cardio in the morning, then usually the 12:30 class is more sculpt or vice versa. We're gonna do some dance cardio, follow along. When I started live streaming, I thought it was really important that Morgan join me in some of the videos.
I'm going live in 15 minutes. I hope that you, oh yes, and Morgan is too, very exciting.
So many people are quarantined with their partners, their roommates, with people, or they're FaceTiming people in to do workouts with. So I really wanted to showcase him in some of the videos, and he joins me usually one video a day, and he's been such a trooper.
Morgan's in the background. He is my videographer today.
I like to say that his new job is my videographer and my lighting director, and helping me with the music and all the tech stuff behind. I am so lucky to have him, and he's been just a real source of strength for me during this time.
Thank you, Morgan, for coming in.
Back to his computer.
Unfortunately, we had planned to have our wedding in September. However, a really big vendor of ours pulled out, and so we're kind of starting from scratch. I think the plan is to still do September if we can. We'll probably just do it in a smaller capacity and make it a little bit more intimate. We're just trying to stay positive about it. We're both healthy, we're both working, and a lot of people don't have either. So I think that's the wedding plan right now. It's been really fun to be able to take my relationships with a lot of my celebrity clients and do Instagram lives. I've done some live workouts with Hannah Brofman, Kate Bock, Hunter McGrady, Elsa Hosk.
Thank you, Megan.
I'm used to seeing them a couple times a week in my classes, and so I get to see them, they get to see me, we get to work out together. After my second class, I often will then take a shower. I'll just take a moment, I'll change into regular clothes, and then I have like my business hat on, I'm behind my computer.
I am back in my office, aka my bedroom. I've got my chips and I'm gonna do some work.
I'm answering hundreds of emails, making sure everything is looking good on the back end of my app. I'm dealing with fulfillment center. I sell equipment on my website, so making sure if anyone has questions about their equipment orders. I am in the midst of making ankle weights and hand weights, so I'm communicating with my factory overseas.
Very exciting. Do you like it?
Yes.
And then I'm also building out content for the next day.
New playlists, outreach, there's email, support emails, there's content creation for Instagram, for brand partnerships that I'm working on, so there's a lot.
I am getting thousands of DMs every day. People are sending me their sweaty selfies.
I promise you, every sweaty selfie that you send me, I see. If there's anything I can do, please reach out. Your messages on Instagram have been overwhelming.
I keep getting feedback that it just feels like a sense of normalcy, and it feels like I'm, you know, holding them accountable if I am going live, that they need to stick to a schedule, because, you know, in this weird world that we're in when we're self-quarantined, you know, time and day kind of can shift around. There's something really powerful in that. I really take as much time as I can each day to respond to as many people as I can.
I'd love to know how everyone's feeling. Leave a comment in the box below.
The Sculpt Society is beat-based, so whether you're doing dance cardio or sculpting, it's on the beat of the music. I feel like my second job is a DJ. I will sift through hundreds of songs, counting the beats per minute on my phone. I'll be tapping each song out. That takes me a long time.
I'm trying to come up with a little fresh grooves today. Morgan, are you gonna show me your moves to help me out? No.
Music is so, so important to the vibe of the class.
If good songs come on, I can't help myself. It's just the best time.
I like to just keep natural nails. I'd say 9 times out of 10, you won't see me with nail polish on. I do like some self-tanner, I'm not gonna lie. When you are on camera all the time and you're pale, you sometimes just want a little color on your skin, at least I do. So I will do a little at-home self-tanner. I like Saint-Tropez and then Tan Luxe as well. Sometimes I go a little overboard and I look like an Oompa Loompa, but I feel like I've mastered the light self-tanner. It's been really tough for me to separate when work and personal life ends and starts because my studio is in my apartment. I have struggled with that a little bit.
You're staying hydrated.
Very hydrated. You making fun of me?
Yeah.
I'm a really big believer in intuitive eating and eating real good food. And that's like my number one top question I get from people is like, what's your diet? I'm like, I do not diet. I went through years of your typical like early 20s body confidence issues.
I literally have done every single diet you can think of. And it wasn't until I shifted how I was talking to myself and my approach to food and intuitive eating that things truly were able to change.
I'm a big chip fan. Give me a bag of tortilla chips and it will likely be gone. And then at night, my fiance and I like to cook really simply. We'll do roasted vegetables over a big green salad, keeping it simple. We've been actually probably ordering in a little bit more than usual, trying to support our local businesses, our local restaurants. And then lately I have had a bowl of ice cream every night as my dessert. I typically try and stay away from sugar at night, but again, I'm just taking the pressure off. I'm leaning in, and if I feel like ice cream, like, I'm gonna have it. My fiance and I love to wind down and just watch TV and hang. We've absolutely fallen into the Tiger King binge watching. We are about to start Ozark season 3. And then, what other reality show are we watching, Morgan?
McMillions.
Oh yeah, and McMillions, sorry. I'm a big believer in taking a rest day. I love an Epsom salt bath. I have a foam roller at home that I'll use. I've got stretch videos on the Sculpt Society app that I encourage my clients to use post-workout. And I also have some like deep heat, some like Tiger Balm that's nice for some sore muscles.
I have been using, of course, CBD drops a lot during this time.
That has absolutely curbed a little bit of my anxiety that I know that we're all feeling.
I know all of us are feeling stressed, we're feeling anxiety, so make sure you're packing your day with little breaks that give you a little mood boost.
So really listening to your body, and I always say, you know, you don't have to do hours of exercise a day, especially when we're in quarantine at home. Take the pressure off. Maybe today you're just stretching and you're meditating, and that's perfectly fine.
Right, it's been a very long day. I just got out of the shower. Some go-to body lotions for me is this Vanny Cream, Necessaire, and then Caudalie. So I kind of go between the three.
Of course, I wash my face before bed.
I just usually need a serum or an oil because my skin is so dry. I love Estee Lauder's Advanced Nighttime Repair. I let that sit for like 30 seconds and then I'll put a nice rich cream on. I'm loving this Skin Food Original Rich Cream. I'll just put like a little bit of this on because it is really thick. Spread it on. Sometimes I will add Drunk Elephant F-Bomb for just like an extra hydrating mask, and I'll sleep in this. And that's it.
I've been going to bed around 10 p.m. People underestimate the power of sleep. Sleep is super important. I make time for that. I indulge in it. I'll get into bed. I really try, as cheesy as it sounds, go through things that I'm grateful for.
I end every day with just so much gratitude for being able to do what I love to do. I just feel really, really lucky.
For me, fitness is my moving meditation. It's how I get into my body. It's how I feel awake. And I know I keep saying it's powerful, but there's something really powerful about moving your body in whatever way feels good for you. And then I'll read, or I will answer some DMs, which I know I shouldn't be doing late at night. And my fiance gets very annoyed with me that I do that, but I do often go through some DMs. I'll answer some DMs and then lights are out.
Thank you. And I'll see you next time. Good night, guys.